Everybody, and welcome to this video on who are my best customers and what I need to do about the other customers. Now every business knows whether they are profitable or not, but not all the businesses knows that who are the best customers and whom I need to work on them. So let's quickly look at the business requirements. So we have quite a few business requirements over here about a model and about loyal customers. Let me highlight the keywords over here. So the keywords over here are the model, loyal customers, must retain them, and so on. You can check them. Now let me talk about the model which I will be using over here. So who is a good customer? A customer who has been with me for a long time and who has been having recent activities with me, of course that's a good customer. How about the customer who comes back to me again and again? And how about the customer who generates money for me? So RFM, that's the standard model, and that is combined together. This is over here, it works together, combine all those things, and based upon them we get the segmentation of our customers, customer segmentation. So now let me briefly tell you about the data. So this is the data I'll be using over here. This is this sample superstore data, and order date is over here. Based upon this we will make the count of the visits, how long the customer has been with the business. This is the customer ID, the name of the customer is also here, and of course the sales. So that is the monetary value, and of course from here we'll get the recency and the visits. Let me briefly explain the implementation of the RFM model. So this is this is based upon the data set which I showed you before. So we look at the min and max values, and then the customer data comes in, okay, and based upon these min and max values, categories are created, and a category is assigned a number from 1 to 5. The reason being, there are a lot of difference over here. This frequency of this recency can be in thousands of days. The frequency can be from 0 for a new customer to 20 plus, and this can be from few hundred to several thousand. So we bring them at a common ground, and then of course we use an average of them, and based upon the average we segregate the customers and we segregate the customers. Now let me show you the system which is implemented for customer segmentation and segregation using Tableau. Now let me first briefly explain the system to you. Over here we have the customer IDs, and on over here the y-axis we have the RFM customer category which I explained to you in the last slide. This is the average line, and these are the 4 and 5 categories of my customers, and of course this is color coded, and from here I can do an analysis, and if I scroll across it I can see all my customers and I can view them customers selectively also. Let me show it to you. Say for example I would only like to look at the customers who are in this category high, and I want to compare them with the medium ones. So I can do this, right? And there's the comparison over here, and as I move the mouse over here I can see the, you can see itself that the categories and everything, and of course I can do a lot of analysis based upon this data. There is some more analysis over here. Over here I have the discount, and on the x-axis I have the customer category, and I have an almost a Gaussian curve over here. What is interesting over here is that I don't have the stars, the star customers. So I can of course so those star customers are not getting any discount, what this graph shows. So at the cost of their discount, not getting them discount, all these customers are getting a discount. That's all folks, thanks for watching, and you are welcome to ask easy questions. Have a good time.